an understanding of what the mechanism is for many of these autoimmune neuropsychiatric disorders. As I mentioned, one of the components is the trigger of the infectious agent, again, whether they be bacterial, viral, or fungal, or even environmental. Our body normally will produce antibodies that recognize these infectious agents, which is the whole premise by which we get vaccinations. So that the body will be able to take the time necessary to produce these B cells that produce these antibodies and be ready and available such that when the actual infectious agent does occur, or the time from when we actually get a chronic infection or something that's acute, the body has to respond and make new antibodies. Unfortunately, in these individuals, the antibodies that are made cross-react with neurologic receptors. It's in a process that we call molecular mimicry, or in some cases, it might be better known as what we call friendly fire in wartime. So these antibodies and different types of immune components will attack the brain and different parts of the brain, and they will produce these different types of heterogeneous neuropsychiatric symptoms. Often, and in many cases, patients then become placed on a regimen of anti-anxiety, antipsychotic, antidepressant, and many other medications. But in patients who have these infection-triggered autoimmune condition, the underlying etiology or the underlying root is really the infection and the immune system.